Hey, friends and family. I had to give myself some time to calm down. Jason and I had a rude awakening this morning. Luckily, I had a short shift, and I was home from work. Even though I was asleep when my daughter started screaming in terror. So Chubacha, that's Jason's dog, is now officially completely an outside only dog. He will no longer be allowed in the house. Jason fell asleep and had forgotten to shut his door. And when Cherokee opened her bedroom door, he attacked Cherokee's cat, Echo. And in, you know, she's screaming in terror. I know I'm not gonna be able to, I didn't know what to do, so I, you know, get the dog by the collar, is trying to yank him to his senses. He's so gone and deep into what he's trying to do to the cat. Jason managed to get the cat out of his mouth, and when the dog didn't even have his eyes open. He couldn't look because the cat was trying to fight back, you know, scratching and clawing. Jason got the cat out of the dog's mouth, the dog latched onto his arm. Cherokee had to, Jason, you know, was like, I haven't even had a dog in a long time, and but Jason started screaming, hollered for Cherokee to get a kitchen knife because the dog wasn't letting go. It was like he was possessed. Jason told me to use the knife to pry his mouth open, and I was terrified to put this knife in the dog's mouth. Part of me was, I didn't want to accidentally injure Jason further, and part of me was, what if he turns on me? But I did get his mouth pried open, and when Jason ran to the kitchen sink with his arm, I dragged the dog outside, and outside. He did try to turn on me. He nipped at me. He didn't sink full teeth into me, but he did nip me. I've got a little nick on my lower ankle at the top of my foot. He's officially an all outside dog now, and my instinct is to put him down. I hate to say that. I loved animals. I wanted to be a veterinarian when I was a little girl. I love that dog too. But he has a side of him that is uncontrollable. He was not obeying Jason, and Jason's his master, and he bit his own master, nipped me. Echo seems to have come out of it reasonably unscathed. I thought he would hide for a couple of days. He only hid for a couple of hours. I called Cherokee when I got to the hospital with Jason, and while we were waiting for assistance, and I told her, make sure, you know, clean, fill his dish, you know, his water dish with clean water, and fill up his food bowl for him. Sometimes she's a little stingy because she's afraid he's too pudgy. He is a little pudgy. But I told her, don't be stingy, be generous. So, you know, he's not wandering around the house, but he's not hiding either. He's in the bedroom with Cherokee. If she comes out, he's back. You know, he's following her like he always does. She came into my room a little while ago to talk to me. You know, y'all need to defuse. And I have a tendency when I'm really overstressed about something not to talk too much to them, because I don't want to stress them out. Cherokee complains that I don't talk enough, and that's I just don't want them to. I don't want to stress them out, and I don't want them to know how stressed I am. But you know, at this moment, you know, like I said, he's permanently an outside dog, no matter how hot or cold it gets out there. I got some pallets. I got two pallets outside. I've been itching for a project to do with them. So, you know, I don't think it's quite enough wood to build a doghouse with for him. But, you know, I work at Home Depot. I can get wood. So. I tried to take a nap because I do have to work tonight. I'm gratefully scheduled for another short shift like I was last night. Not a full all-nighter, just a half a night. And at the moment, like I said, I'm grateful. Normally I would be grumpy about not having a full shift, especially since, you know, I have an hour commute to work. It's actually an hour and 10 minutes. But I only dozed off for a few minutes, and then I just back awake. Hopefully after I get home from work tonight, I'll be able to sleep. So there's no sense in lying there torturing myself with, oh, I need to sleep and I can't. Jason's got a few stitches. He's got a scratch on his side. He's fingernail coming off here on this hand. They didn't want to take it off, even though it was half off already. They taped it into place with the Band-Aid. I'm expecting, with my experience with nails and having lost a couple of toenails in the past off my big toe, due to an injury in an accident, I'm expecting the nail will fall off in a few days, you know, but it'll grow back. It'll look funky for a little while it's not there, but it'll grow back. And he's got an antibiotic that the doctor at the hospital prescribed to him, because contrary to popular belief, dogs have nasty mouths. And think about the places they lick. No, that's not a cleaner than a human mouth. So he's got an antibiotic. He's got some pain meds. But the pain medicine is a really strong medicine. So after he ate when we got home, I gave him some ibuprofen. And I'm okay with having a, I just want a boring life. I really do. I don't need this excitement in the adventures of Renetta. I don't want to live the adventures of Renetta. I want to live Renetta. Just smooth Renetta. Just, you know, but everybody's still alive. Everybody's still breathing, and I managed to get Jason to the hospital without getting stopped by a police officer. Yay me. All right. I think I'm going to leave out some details about that. It's not how I would normally drive. Thank goodness. All right. So, but friends and family, we love you. We miss you. You know, don't be afraid to give us a call and, you know, call Jason and check on him. It's okay to call and check on me too, you know, because we miss you and we still love you, even though we're far away. Okay? Peace.